Hey, it's Scott. What I want to go ahead and touch on is a quick review of one of the most common questions asked to Dr. Broselow and Dr. Entebbe. And that's simply, whether it's back at the rig or on the hospital side, what about the fat kids? And why that comes into play is when you measure a kid head to heels, or if you go with Entebbe and you just know the age, but you take one look at this kid and you're like, you know what? It ain't gonna fit. Why this is huge is twofold. The first of which is when it comes to equipment. So with that in mind, on the Broselow tape, it actually has a short description, i.e. disclaimer, saying when you're dealing with equipment, that length is where it's at. Meaning skinny or fat, don't care, length is where it's at to figure out the size of the tube. When you're dealing with Entebbe, both on the app and in the book, it has a very similar disclaimer saying that when it comes to equipment, that age or length is where it's at. So with that in mind, when it comes to equipment, simply go ahead and trust what it says. That's important. Now, the other issue though is when it comes to drugs, right? Whereas you measure this kid and you look and they're falling off of the Broselow tape and you're like, you know what, this is a problem. Can you go ahead and bump them up a color when it comes to drugs? Honestly, many people tell you sure, if your medical director's okay with it. And interestingly, both the Broselow tape and the Entebbe book and app actually make allusions to that as well. So why that comes into play is on the drug side. Specifically on the Broselow tape, remember, it tells you a weight on the bottom. And on the Entebbe book or app, it says a weight, but specifically on Entebbe, it also says ideal weight. That's crucial. Because whether it's Broselow or Entebbe, they both list weights that are ideal body weight. And ideal body weight is a fancy way of describing this is what you should weigh, not what you actually weigh. And why that's a really big deal is 99%+ of the emergency drugs that you and I give to sick kids every day are based on ideal body weight. Meaning if you're pushing epi during an arrest, it's calculated based on what you should weigh. If you're going to the pediatric ICU and you're starting a fancy drip of something, chances are it's calculated based on what you should weigh. If you're a bad burn and you're figuring out fluids, it's based on what you should weigh. And if you crack your femur and you're giving morphine, fentanyl, ketamine, dilaudid, they're all calculated based on what you should weigh. That's why Entebbe says you're a 3-year-old white, 15 kilos ideal weight. Or if you look at Broselow and it see white up top, you're gonna see 15 to 18 kilos on the bottom, both of which describe ideal body weight. So when you're dealing with equipment, moral of the story, skinny or fat, don't care. What the app, the book, or the tape says, chances are it's probably the equipment that you ought to use. When it comes to drugs, if you appear to be of ideal body weight, great, use what's on the tape, use what's on the app. If you look at this kid and they're a little bigger than they ought to be, if your medical director allows and you want to go ahead only for meds, you can go ahead, feel free, bump them up a color. Because if you're a squatty little squirt, can you bump them down a color? Sure, we just don't see that nearly as often as we see the other side. Equipment, go with the guide. When it comes to drugs, remember they are ideal body weight. And that is ideally what you go ahead and give.